Hi everyone and welcome to 10 and Tech from IT Chronicles. I'm Kirsty McGowan and I'm here today with my co-host Shane Carlson. Hiya Shane.
Hello.
And Kathleen Wilson.
Hello.
And we're here today with James Willett from Neustar. Hiya James.
Hello everyone.
So James, you guys recently put out a report talking about how the face of cyber attacks on the internet are changing, and you guys talk a lot about, you know, the nature of DDoS attacks and how things are happening today, not only, you know, against governments, foreign entities, things that are happening, you know, to businesses. Talk to us a little bit about, you know, why you guys put out the report and, you know, some of the things you guys are seeing in this ever-changing landscape of digital security.
Yeah, so we put the report out primarily because we want to raise awareness to, you know, the ever-changing threats that are out there. This is an area that Neustar actually has services in. So we want to make sure that what we see in the day-to-day activities of mitigating DDoS attacks and other web-based attacks, we're being able to provide that information back out to the general public for any sort of, trends or unique characteristics that we see, that we're able to provide that information as well.
So do you want to tell us just a little bit about Neustar? Just give us a little snippet of what you actually do.
Yeah, so the 30-second elevator speech is essentially the component that we're talking about here is our digital performance and digital defense side of the business. So we're focused on internet infrastructure availability, and website and web application protection, essentially. So the key focus within the defense part of the business is mostly around web applications and web application attacks. We have performance monitoring services. We have mitigation services like DDoS mitigations, web application firewall services, that type of thing, to help our customers make sure that they stay online.
Someone else?
No, no, it's for James. I was waiting for that long, pregnant pause. I apologize. Yeah. So I guess, who's your target market for your customers? Like, you know, what type of organizations benefit greatly from your services?
Yeah, so typically the target market for us is anyone that has some sort of reason to be online, right? So whether it's an e-commerce site or whether it's an organization that's looking to make sure that they maintain their brand awareness and not have issues on the website that they might have. So in many of the situations for our customers, seconds matter, milliseconds matter for performance. And then on the flip side of that, you know, organizations spend a lot of money to market to their customers and to bring them to their online applications. If those online applications are unavailable when they get there, that's a lot of wasted effort, a lot of wasted resources and dollars. So making sure that those types of services are always available is one of the key components to what we do. So the target market that we have is not necessarily vertically focused, but there's certain use cases of organizations that look to basically ensure that their uptime or their online applications are up and up.
What do you guys see kind of as the greatest threat, you know, in the corporate environment? You know, I know the last couple of years we've seen a lot of increase in, you know, very targeted spear phishing campaigns, you know, especially in the defense contractor space. I mean, they're literally going out, finding the personal email addresses of key people within the company, you know, trying to get them to fall for various spear phishing techniques. Is that still very prominent? You know, what's kind of happening out there that's of greatest concern right now to a lot of corporate entities?
Yeah, what's interesting for us is, you know, you continue to see, you know, denial of service has been around for, you know, 15 years, you know, prevalently around for 15 years. And we continue to see those types of activities being used. But in the past, it's been, I purely as a bad actor want to disrupt the service of an organization. Now you're starting to see that morph to be more of a targeted type of an attack. I may want to do, you know, what we call smokescreen attack, where I launch some sort of DDoS attack, and while all of the resources are fighting this, mitigating this DDoS attack, I'm working some sort of exploit on, you know, another set of systems or what have you, so that I can gain access to systems because sort of the eyes are off of the, you know, that security people will take their eye off the ball focused on one threat vector when there's another, you know, there's a potential of another opening somewhere else. So we find that DDoS attacks are used in not just as purely a denial of service capability anymore, but it's actually used as more of a smokescreen type threat. The continued expansion for, higher bandwidth for every device that's online, the explosion of IoT with more and more devices coming online. This is just opening the door to make it easier and easier for denial of service attacks to be accomplished. There's several different botnets out there. Every day you hear about another botnet that's sucked up, you know, another different class of IoT devices or something like that. And these attacks have gone from, you know, what was 15 years ago, a 20 gig attack would generally take an organization offline, to attacks that are, you know, earlier this year, 1.7, 1.8 terabits. There's very few organizations out there, if any, that can that's purely a commercial enterprise that can withstand those types of attacks. They have to have some sort of help when it's the volumetric attacks.
Are we getting better at seeing these attacks quicker? I mean, we've heard in the past about we find people have been sitting inside our walls basically for a long time before they're actually realized. Are we improving in those sorts of metrics?
Yeah, one of the things that we see is that there's definitely from a general standpoint, we're seeing an increase in the awareness of the attacks and the activity to be able to acknowledge and identify these types of attacks. Quicker time to mitigate is definitely what we see. We do the report that Shane mentioned earlier. We do a report twice a year, and nearly every time that we do a new report, we see that shrink just a little bit more. One of the reasons behind that is that a lot of our organizations that we go out and survey or that we question and things like that, there's a lot more acknowledgement that these are threats that need to be dealt with. So, you know, I think the last report had like 98% of the organizations that were polled have put some sort of mitigation capability in place. So having that acknowledgement and awareness is going to naturally improve the ability to actually see those attacks and start to do something about them.
Great. Yeah, I get a lot of press releases coming at me every day because I do a lot of writing, and there are every day there's a pile of press releases come through my inbox on security breaches.
Yes.
So, I mean, whether we're just finding out about them a bit better and acknowledging them more quickly, or is the volume of security breaches constantly increasing now?
Yeah, and that's actually, if you know, it's getting easier and easier. You know, it used to be that there was a certain skill and a certain, you know, as tradecraft to be able to execute these types of breaches, or, you know, be able to, you know, it took concerted effort to create a botnet, you know, and go out and write the malware or the code to be able to create these bots and have a command and control center and everything else. Now there's sites you can go to where you can, you know, literally just rent a botnet. You know, it's botnet for hire. You go out, you put in a credit card, and, you know, how many hosts do you want to actually use in your attack, or what bandwidth do you want to use in your attack? What's the duration you want your attack to be? And within 5 minutes, you can be, you know, sending a denial of service attack to any organization in the world. And those types of things, you know, the sale of ransomware code, the sale of malware code, the ability to rent botnets, all of this has made it easier for, you know, people that have misaligned intentions or bad intentions to be able to go do this. They don't have to have those skills anymore necessarily to do it all from scratch.
That's scary.
Yeah.
So I know, Black Hat's wrapping up, I think today, this week. You know, anything interesting come out of Black Hat this week? You know, anything, any, you know, major revelations? I haven't been tracking too closely, so I'm curious.
Yeah, I actually, and admittedly, I didn't spend any time at Black Hat this year, but we've got an entire set of team, you know, various teams and several members of the company that are, that attend Black Hat. I've been getting some information fed back to me and things like that. You know, we do events there to, you know, bring in our customers, sort of a, you know, goodwill type thing, as well as try to gain additional customers. But I think the general thought is that there's always going to be some level of layered defense and layered security that's going to be necessary. You know, there's going to every company that's there has something that they solve for. And finding those particular companies that layer on those levels of security and don't just have some sort of, you know, one-time use case that, you know, this particular tool solves this particular problem, but can span, you know, some level of multiple layers of security. Those are the organizations that I think are really going to find success into the next, the next round of defending against these types of attacks and bad actors that we see out there.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for your time today, James. Always interesting when we talk about security topics and kind of what people are doing in the security world these days. So appreciate your time very much, and hope to see you out there in the industry.
Yeah, thank you very much for having me today.